Blood and urine taken at the postmortem were submitted for forensic toxicology testing. This included testing for common drugs of abuse such as cannabis, heroin, and amphetamines. I've had the opportunity to review the results, and cocaine was detected in Roxanne Mitchell's blood and urine. They were at levels not sufficient to cause death, but did indicate recent moderate abuse of cocaine.
So the cocaine can't be directly linked to her cardiac arrest?
Persistent abuse of cocaine over a period of time can cause abnormalities of the heart, but there was no evidence of this at post-mortem. The levels found would certainly have been sufficient to impair judgment. Also, the contribution of cold water immersion is likely to have led to the circumstances that caused the cardiac arrest.